Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Here are some tips for getting the most from the Messages app on your Mac. So the primary purpose of the Messages app is to allow you to communicate with other people. And there are a variety of different tools and techniques in the Messages app to help you do that more effectively. I'm going to show you the Messages app here in macOS Tahoe 26 using Apple's iMessage system. A lot of these techniques won't work if you're conversing with somebody who's using SMS or RCS in a non-Apple device. So let's say you get a simple message like this one here, and you want to respond to it. Now, you may be tempted to emphasize the words "very much" with capital letters, just putting them in all caps. But I find it's really easy to forget you can use some rich text in a message. For instance, if you go to Format here, you see you can easily bold text in a message. Command B works just like it does in any word processor. So you could do Command I for italic, Command U for underline. You could even choose strike through here in the format menu. So I can very easily make this text bold just to give it a little emphasis, or even bold and italic. Now, if you want to go beyond that, notice here under format, there are a bunch of text effects. So for instance, if I wanted to use not here, you could see I could just have it bounce up and down like that. You could also just control click, right click, or two finger click on the selected text and select text effects from here. There's a whole bunch of different ones that you could use to give some words emphasis. Now, you can also apply an effect to the entire message. And in fact, it's not just the text in the message, but will actually change how the entire Messages app looks for that person, whether they're on a Mac, iPhone, or iPad. If you click the plus button here, you've got message effects. And then you can choose from a variety of things here. For instance, I can have confetti fill their messages window. I could have the message itself slam into place, or lasers emanate from it, or just have it get really large like that and fall back. There are a whole bunch of different ones that you could use, even ones that kind of play it down a little bit like this. So you can pick one of these and they will get the effect when they receive and then view the message. Now, also notice here that there's some text underlined in the message they sent to me. This isn't because they chose to underline it. It would have been a dark black underline if that was the case. It's because this is something I can now click on. The Messages app recognizes that this is talking about an event at a time, and I can click on it like this, and it will try to figure out what event to add to the calendar. I can change which calendar to add it to. You could see it comes up with a title, but I could edit that title. It puts it in this space here, but I could change that. I can even go into details here, and then I could really change tons of different things about this before using the add to calendar button. And when I do add this to the calendar, it adds it quietly. It doesn't launch the calendar app to get in the way of what I was doing. If you find these videos valuable, consider joining the more than 2,000 others that support MacMost at Patreon. You get exclusive content, course discounts, and more. You can read about it at macmost.com/Patreon. Now, in addition to being able to send text, you can also send audio. I'm not talking about dictating. You can certainly use the dictation functions on your Mac to dictate text into the messages field, just like you can in Mail or Pages or anywhere else. But you can also click this button here, and then you can record some audio. So you could speak or whatever you want, put it here in the audio, press stop, and you can click at the time here again to continue recording, and then you can send it to them. And then they'll get the audio recording and they could play it back on their end. Another thing you can add to some text that you're typing or just send by itself is an animated GIF. Now, we're all used to seeing these in messages and social media systems, but it's really easy to add something here. Just click the plus button and then choose images here. And then it's going to give you all of these images that you could easily just attach to a text message, and you can search for them. You could search for birthday and get things related to that. And then you could just select that item and it adds it here in the message, and then they see it animated on the other end. You also may notice a lot of other things here when you click the plus button. For instance, a very new one is polls. So this is a new feature in macOS Tahoe where you get to actually put different choices here, and the person receiving it gets to select their choice. You write some regular text here, and you normally wouldn't send this to one other person, although there are situations like this where you might. So here I've added a bunch here. I typed a message, and I can send it. And now the other person can actually choose from one of these places and doesn't have to respond to you. They just click on it, and then you would get to see the response. If you're in a group chat, obviously this is more useful as an actual poll where you can then count up the votes. Now, another option you've got here is after you type a message, instead of pressing return to send it now, you can click the plus button and choose send later. So you can choose now a date and time to send the message, and it will get sent then. Especially handy if you know somebody is busy and you don't want to bother them now, or you want a message to get to them at a certain time when they're most likely to be able to take the action and respond to what you're asking. Now, you don't have to respond with a message every time, but if you do feel you need some little bit of a response to it, you can use a tap back. The way to do a tap back is you control click, right click, or two finger click on the message, and it can be the last one you received or an earlier one. And then you can select one of these symbols here, like a thumbs up, for instance, or you can click here to choose any emoji. Now, when you do that, instead of it appearing as a new message below, it's just going to appear as this little annotation to the actual message that was sent. They will see it the same way. Now, of course, another thing you can do here is you can include photos. If you select that, you can now view your photo library. You can search it. But notice here at the bottom, it says location is included. That's right. There's GPS location information in photos. So when you send one to somebody, they know where you were when you took that photo. This warning is good, but how do you actually make it so that they don't get the location information? Well, you can't do that in messages. You need to do it in photos. If you launch photos and you go to photos settings, then you go to general, look for sharing, and there's a checkbox for include location information. Uncheck that. And now when you go to include a photo, you'll see here location not included. Now, whether it's a group chat or it's just another individual, sometimes we want to respond to a message that was there earlier. And it gets confusing if you just respond below because it seems like you're continuing the conversation. You can control click, right click, or two finger click on any earlier message and then use reply. And then this will allow you to respond with something. And then you'll just see this message here and its response. And if they were to respond to it, you would see it underneath. It's kind of like a little sub conversation inside the main one. If you go back to the main conversation here, you'll see your reply below and it will show you what it is you were responding to. The other person will see the same. So it makes conversations a little more natural instead of getting confusing, especially if the other person asks you three things in a row and you want to respond to the first one. Now, when you send a message like this and you realize there's an error in there, there's a mistake that you made, you may be tempted to actually send another message, you know, like this, but you can actually just correct this message. Control click, right click, or two finger click on it, and then choose edit. Then you can go and change the message and then send it again. Note that it says edit it underneath, and you can click there and see the original message. They could see that too. So you can't really use it to kind of hide something that you sent that you shouldn't have. It's really more for just kind of correcting grammatical and spelling errors and things like that, so the conversation isn't cluttered with all sorts of corrections as new messages. Now let's talk about group chats for a minute here. So let's say you're in a group chat like this one, and there are a lot of people sending a lot of messages, and you're just getting tons of alerts. All these notifications are coming up all the time. You can silence those by clicking up here on the icon that represents the conversation, which brings up the information here on the right, showing you things about this conversation. Here you've got hide alerts. Turn that on, and now you won't get all the new notifications for this conversation. You'll still be getting the messages. You'll just check them when you want and won't be interrupted when new ones come in. Also note that if you want to leave a group conversation like this, there's a button here for that. It's grayed out here because it requires that there be at least three other people besides you in the group. Then this will be red and you can click on it. Also, there's a lot of functionality hidden behind clicking on the icon here to bring up the sidebar. So for instance here, if there have been any photos exchanged in this conversation, you can click on Photos here, and then it'll show them all. You can select one and actually drag it out to make it a file or move it to another app. Control click, right click, or two finger click to view it larger, or save it to your photos. You also might see other things, like for instance, links from the conversation listed here, other documents and files that are also part of this conversation. And you could easily grab these and export them. And also, if they're large attachments or large photos, videos, you can control click, right click, or two finger click and delete them so they're not taking up space on your Mac or in iCloud. Now, when somebody sends you a message and it arrives on one of your devices, that person will see delivered underneath the message. And then as soon as you actually look at the message in the Messages app, it will say read. I know a lot of people like to go to Messages settings, and then under iMessage, you could turn off read receipts, but you don't have to do that for everybody. You can do it for individuals. As long as you have it turned on there in settings, then you can go to the info for this conversation and then scroll down. And in addition to be able to hide alerts, you also can turn off read receipts for just that conversation. Now, another thing you can do here in the right sidebar is you can share location with somebody else. You can request their location and then they can accept that, or you can share your location and both of those will then continue to update until you revoke that by going here again. But you can also just send your current location and it's just a one-time thing. Also here on the right side is share focus status. So when you have that turned on, if you've got Do Not Disturb turned on or some other focus mode, they will see that and maybe know why it is you can't respond to them right now. For instance, here back in this conversation, this person is going to turn on Do Not Disturb mode. And you could see that it comes on right there. And if they turn that off, it will go away. Now, the standard way a lot of us use the Messages app on Mac is to simply have this one window, your list of conversations here on the left, and then the messages within that conversation on the right. But you could also break out the conversations into separate windows. Just double click on a conversation and you can see now it breaks it out into a separate window like this. And I could resize it and position it and put it somewhere else. If I want, I could have another window here with this conversation and you can place them as you want, leave them open. You can use all the windows switching techniques like Command and then the backtick key to go between the windows and messages, or Control and the down arrow to enter App Expose and see all the windows for the current app, in this case, messages. Then select one to bring that one to the front. Message now has some pretty powerful filtering built in. If you go to Messages Settings and then you go to General, you'll see here first unknown senders, and you can screen unknown senders. Then you could also filter likely spam as well. So I've got both of those turned on. In order to see those messages when they come in, I could just click on the filter button here and I could view my regular messages, but I could also see the ones that have been filtered into unknown senders and the ones filtered into spam. So if somebody sends you an important message and you don't see it, remember to check in here to see if it's been filtered into one of these two categories. And here's a bonus tip. If you go back into settings here, Messages is one of those apps that actually allows you to customize the alert sound on your Mac. Most apps just have the default notification sound, but here in the general settings, you've got message receive sound, and you could set it to a whole bunch of different sounds here, or you could set it to none, so it silently gives you the notifications. And there are also a ton more useful settings here. There are other useful things you could do by clicking on the plus button. Some of these require Apple intelligence, others do not. And there are a lot of features that you could find here in the menus as well. So if you like some of these techniques, you may want to explore more in Messages to see what other things are in there that you might find a use for. I hope you found this useful. Thanks for watching. If you liked this video, click the thumbs up button below to let me know. I publish new tutorials each weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out.